is it that we, as people and as, of course, as musicians, come from? So much of our identity is bound up in our influences, especially our early ones, particularly those with our teachers, our family, our peers, and of course what we heard and enjoyed coming up. With this series, and of course with its upcoming and accompanying album, this is exactly the notion that I wish to explore, particularly within the works of Giovanni Zamboni, an Italian lutenist living in Rome in the 18th century. Of course, by this time, the lute had largely become passé. However, here was, of course, the late lute master Zamboni himself. Now, that being said, of course, he was a multi-instrumentalist, and also he had a day job. However, what makes his music, in particular, especially worthy of examination is the dichotomy of taste. While so much of it is tinged with the notes of Italian melody and florid embellishment, it is also redolent with an entirely different taste. And that is the Germanic Stil Galant. Just prior to the publication and composition of his Sonate di Intavolatura di Liuto, Zamboni was able to enjoy the performance of the remarkable Silvius Leopold Weiss, one of the most prominent lutenists of the 18th century. What is especially remarkable about the Weissian style is its marriage of the French and German elements in the Stil Galant. Now, what you're going to notice in the performance following, especially remarkable, will be the resolutions of onbeat dissonances, and also the elegance of its careful counterpoint. So then, where do our more formative influences end, and our more mature tastes begin? More specifically, what we're going to look for in just a moment is where do the more melodically florid Italian influences end in the face of the German Stil Galant? This is the question that I wish to pose to you all, with this the first in a line of productions, now including Giovanni Zamboni's Ninth Sonata for the Arch Lute.